Please pause for the moment of silence. Please stand for the pledges. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And now for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Good morning, Bobcats. I'm Patrick Chippendale.
And I'm Chris Tewksbury. Welcome back to Bobcat TV.
Today we have some information about the NISD Aquatic Facility,
as well as some more information about Kindness Month.
Stay tuned for these stories and more.
Bobcat TV starts now. Students, don't forget that there's no school on Monday the 15th in honor of President's Day.
Now here is Coach Melbourne with some information about the newly built NISD Aquatic Center.
Some of the pictures you're going to be seeing of the facility, we must tell you that this is the result of the 2017 bond package, which included this natatorium. You're looking at a pool, a facility that can be converted. It's a stretch 63-meter pool that can do diving at the same time it's operating a 50-meter Olympic-sized pool. For high school, we're using just the 25-yard format at this time. You're looking at 934,000 gallons of water being heated a third of a degree every hour by the boilers out there. We recently invited all the teams to come out on a Saturday for an hour block just to see the facility. It was amazing, ladies and gentlemen. We do have the crown jewel of aquatic centers in the North Texas area. I dare say almost the entire state of Texas as well.
Next week, for Kindness Month, we have dress-up days to celebrate World Kindness Spirit. On Tuesday, wake up and be kind for PJ Day. On Wednesday, team up for kindness for Jersey Day. Thursday, wear red, white, and blue. And on Friday, show that Byron is kind by wearing your school spirit items.
Phyllis Wheatley was an influential African-American poet and activist that helped form the voice for African-American rights in the 1800s. Here is more information in regards to her paramount accomplishments.
Although she was an enslaved person, Phyllis Wheatley was one of the best-known poets in the pre-19th century America. Educated and enslaved, Wheatley was the abolitionist's illustrative testimony that African Americans could be both artistic and intellectual. Her name was a household word among the literate colonists, and her achievements acted as a catalyst for the rising anti-slavery movement in America.
And now here's some information from Miss Van Houten about returning books and course registration.
Hello. I'm Elaine Van Houten. I am the assistant to the principals here on the third floor. I'm going to talk today about a couple of things. If any students need to check out textbooks, all of the textbooks are stored on the third floor, and you'll come see me with your ID. Check your textbook out, and then you also return textbooks here at the end of the semester. The other thing is, if a student ever needs to schedule an appointment with their assistant principal, and you can just scan this QR code right here. And these are, I think they're all over the building in different places. They should be outside every assistant principal's office, and they're in different walls, I think in the staircases as well. You just scan that, and then you can make your appointment to talk to your assistant principal. Thank you.
Valentine's Day is right around the corner, and if you have that special someone, be sure to buy a beautiful flower arrangement from Byron Blooms.
That's all we have for today. Thank you for watching this edition of Bobcat TV.
See you next time.
Have a great day, Bobcats.